Okay, today we have with us Manish Sharma. He's going to be walking us through all of his journeys. So Manish, welcome to the Data Science with Kunal channel.
Thank you, Kunal, for having me. And hello, everyone. I'm Manish Sharma. I'm a third year electronics student from NMIT Bangalore. I am currently the co-leader of my college ML and DL team. I have 4 to 5 internships under my belt for both deep learning and machine learning, and I'm Kaggle 2x expert.
Awesome, Manish. So now, first thing, let's speak about how you got your group together. Now, in my engineering, I had a student chapter where we used to do things like build Java applications and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But you seem to taken that a notch ahead in your time and are working on ML and AI as a project or as a group. So how did you end up doing that?
So it started when I was in my fifth sem. So there is a teacher called as Jaya ma'am. Shout out to Jaya ma'am. Mm-hmm. So the ma'am was very close to me. She said that, Manish, you are very good at ML and DL. Why not you try to make a group in our college so that you can try to teach the beginner people. And also this is a booming industry and you can try to make a good amount of skills from this. So I thought, yes, why not give it a shot? Then I, with some of my CS friends, we tried and we did some brainstorming. And then we came up with a plan that we can give some kind of seminar. And then we'll check whether the people are interested or not, the students are interested. If they're interested, we'll take them and we'll try to train them with the basic skill sets as well as give some courses which we had earlier. And it started with around 15 to 16 members in the first month. And now we currently have around 2 to 3,000 all over college, including both first year, second year, third year. Generally, the fourth year people are not into this group because they are preparing for the internships, the job area. But we have around 2 to 3,000 people, and I think that is a very large community in itself. And I think being a co-founder of that, I feel special.
You have 2,000 people, and that is a massive scale, right? Like you have to train, and not only train, you have to keep them inspired to continue their journey. So what do you do, one activity that, what is it that you do to come together and practice or learn, and how many trainers do you have who can teach, so how are you placed like that?
So in the beginning, we had around 5 members, I being the one, and still 4 members. So what we thought, we cannot teach all the 2,000 people. We have to build some kind of our right-hand side on the left-hand side people. So they will keep on training the below people. So we started with the bright students who were in CS and they knew some basics of ML and DL. So we taught them a little bit. Then we said them that now you are the team leader for your upcoming students. So now he is motivated that he is some kind of in a head position. So previously I was in the head position. Now I am telling my student that you are the head position now. So now he feels...
So basically, you gave on the leadership.
So now I am giving him the power that now you are the leadership. You have the responsibility. You need to train the below students. Now he has a very good responsibility on himself and he doesn't want to let it go. So he will give his best. Now when he is giving his best, the students which are under him, they'll try to give their best. So my job is done. I have trained my left side people and my right side people. And I have motivated them. The right and left hand side people will motivate their students. So this is how the community will. It's kind of a binary tree, binary search tree. I am at the
networking
second.
Networking to nahi kar rahe ho na.
Nahi, networking nahi kar rahe. I am not like that guy who is like, mere saath aajo, hum tumhe Ferrari dila denge.
Absolutely, absolutely. No, but you're teaching good stuff actually. See, it started with 5 people and 2,000 people are doing it. And so, where did you get all your material from? Like, did you take online free courses, YouTube videos, paid courses? What are the primary sources that you learn from?
So generally, we don't take any of the courses like paid courses. At the beginning, I started to teach them with the courses which I had, like the notes which I had made. And now when a student is motivated, when a student is interested to learn some topic, wo apne aap kar lega. He doesn't need help of others. Always guiding him that, sir, what can I do next? Sir, what can I do next? No. If he is motivated, he will go to his laptop. He'll search what are the things required to learn ML and he'll start learning himself. So is it? Absolutely. It is not compulsory that I should tell each people, do this course and do this course. I should just give him a little guideway that this is the path you should follow. And if you are motivated, you will eventually find your own way. It is not compulsory that I should keep on telling you, ye karo, ye karo, ye karo. So it depends on the student. If he want a paid course, he will take the paid course. If he doesn't want a paid course, he won't take the paid course. He will by himself search from Google, search from article, YouTube, and learn by himself. So this is some kind of community building.
So basically now they are internally motivated to do. Not like, अरे आज तुम कर लो, ये काम कर लो, वो काम कर लो. नहीं, ऐसा नहीं. वो अपने आप पार्ट ढूंढ लेगा. और जिसको नहीं करना है ये, वो निकल जाएगा.
Yeah, simple. If a person needs some kind of motivation every 2 days to do some task, he is not interested in that. If a person is interested in something, he doesn't need the motivation every time. He has the motivation in himself to do the task. Then he considers that task as a activity, as a loving thing. He won't see it as a job, or he won't see it as a hard work kind thing. So agar main apne people ko, yeah, if I tell my students that don't look like this, that I have to study this every day. Just if you are interested in that, if you feel ki haan ye concept mein main achha hoon, if you are very good at that skills and if you want to master that skills, I don't want to motivate you. You will eventually motivate yourself and you will keep on building your pathways.
Sahi hai. And we can speak both Hindi and English. If you are wondering what to do, we can choose both the language, right? Okay.
Kannada bhi baat kar lenge
thoda sa. Sahi hai. Theek hai. Ab now that you've told ki haan community part ho gaya, like you have put the leadership, right? Which means you have a lot of room for learning yourself, right? Because you are leading the pathway into new technologies, right?
In the path of data science.
In the path of data science, right? Now, so in the path of data science, there's a lot of things to do. Like you begin with, let's say, machine learning, simple algorithms like your trees algorithms, and then you move on to, you know, stuff like XGBoost, or then you move on to PyTorch or TensorFlow and all of that thing. There's a general progression that is going on, right? Did you also take a similar path, or was there something that you did different?
I think the path and the guideway, it differs from people to people. Ab jaise let's take an example. I'm an engineering student and now it's lockdown, so I don't need to go to college and I'm hardworking. So I can spend around 6 to 7 hours a day learning some topic. Let's take another example. The guy is little lazy, but he's very smart. So he doesn't need all the 5 to 6 hours to learn some topic. He can learn the same topic within 1 to 2 hours. So it depends on the people to people that how is the path that they are creating. And according to that path, they will analyze themselves. If I need to do this, I know that I have this many hours of time in my hand. I can utilize that hour and I can use that. It's not like that I am compulsorily telling each and every student that everyone should work for 6 hours. No, it depends on the person's ability, person's potential, that how much he knows, how much he is confident on himself. Ki haan, agar 2 ghanta kaam karna hai, he'll do the 2 hours with full dedication and then he can achieve the things.
Sahi hai. Now let's look at your day, Manish. How does your day look like? Let's say you know, in this day, let's say you don't have any other engagements. It's a normal college day, right? So how do you manage your college time, like day-to-day activities, and then also put in the hours that you need to learn or manage the community, right? Okay. So how your day will be looking like?
So let's take an example that it's a normal Monday and I'm in third year and my college is starting. So I don't live in the hostel area, so I live in my home. So the thing is, I need to get up morning 6 o'clock because my college bus comes at 7 o'clock. And I need to go from my home till the place where I take my bus. So in the morning, I don't have much time because first I need to catch my bus. If my bus is missed, I need to go 27 kilometers to reach my college. So when I sit in my bus, I sit in my bus at 7 o'clock in the morning and I reach my college 8:30. So I have 1.5 hours of time. So I believe that learning anything early morning is good. Like if you want to study some concept or if you want to revise some concept, having a peace area with some 30 to 40 minutes of time is good. So what I do, I just sit in the last seat in my bus and I mm-hmm. put on my headphones or earphones. I play some podcast, or if I play some any kind of slight music, so that it disconnects me from the outside world. And then mm-hmm. I'll try to plan my day. That what am I going to do? That is the place where I plan my day. That I'll go to college, oh. I'll finish these mm-hmm. college things. And when I reach home, what are the steps mm-hmm. I need to take? Because when I'm planning my day, I don't need to spend that time in my home sitting, okay, now I have reached home, I will do this, I will do this, I will do this. These times are being utilized in my bus. So when mm-hmm. I make the procedure in my bus, I do all my college studies. And then when I reach home, I look at the schedule which I have made. And based on that schedule, I'll try to cover up each and everything. Generally, my bus time is only meant mm-hmm. for revision and only meant mm-hmm. for making schedules. When I come home wow. around 6 o'clock in the evening, from 6 mm-hmm. to 7, I'll take some rest. And from mm-hmm. 7 to 10 o'clock, I have 3 hours mm-hmm. of time. If I spend these 3 hours very efficiently and very mm-hmm. dedicatedly, mm-hmm. I guess we can do many things in these 3 hours. I can keep on training my model in one laptop and I can keep on learning some podcast from my mobile. Sabke paas 24 ghanta hota hai. We cannot give the reason that I don't have time. Everyone has to make time.
Absolutely, Manish. Now, आपने एक बहुत बहुत अच्छा टॉपिक बोला है, प्लानिंग, राइट? नाउ ऑब्वियसली दिस प्लानिंग पार्ट ऑफ इट माइट नॉट बी देयर फर्स्ट, और इट वाज ऑलवेज देयर विथ यू. लाइक डिड यू नो हाउ टू प्लान अर्ली ऑन?
सो आई कंसीडर मायसेल्फ अ लिटिल ब्राइट स्टूडेंट. आई हैड गुड स्कोर्स इन 10th, बट आई डोंट थिंक दैट हैविंग अ वेरी गुड स्कोर इन 10th इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी ब्राइट. बट स्टार्टिंग में था दैट आई हैड अ लिटिल confidence on myself that even though I have some task which I need to submit tomorrow and mm-hmm. I think that I can do it by myself within one day, that mm-hmm. confidence leads to execution to me. So agar mere paas confidence hai that I can do the planning and I can finish the planning, I can eventually mm-hmm. finish the planning. Yahi kehte na ki don't depend on other people to give you the confidence. First build confidence mm-hmm. for yourself that you can achieve the task. अगर तुम्हारे पास खुद कॉन्फिडेंस है दैट यस मनीष यू कैन डू द टास्क, इवन दो द अदर पर्सन इज टेलिंग नो यू कैन नॉट डू, यू कैन डू. सो द प्लानिंग थिंग व्हिच यू सेड, इट वाज इट स्टार्टेड व्हेन आई वाज इन अराउंड 10th स्टैंडर्ड, बिकॉज 10th इज द फर्स्ट मेन एग्जाम व्हिच वी गिव द एसएसएलसी द फाइनल एग्जाम्स. तो उस टाइम से प्लानिंग स्टार्ट कर लिए थे. एंड देन इवेंचुअली व्हेन आई केम टू 12th, 12th इज अ प्लेस वेर यू इंटरेक्ट विद मेनी पीपल्स ऑल ओवर इंडिया. So you meet all the people who are very smart than you, the people who are lazy but smarter than you. Mm-hmm. So you get to know very rich kind of thinking ability. Ek banda, there is a person who only focuses on hard work. There is a person who only focuses on smart work. There is a person who says that main Bhagwan mein vishwas karta. So when you interact with diverse group of people, you tend to make a common pathway for yourself by listening to every people. You listen to every people, jo tumhe sahi lagta hai, extract that, and based on that, you try to make your plan. Because at last, tumhara choice hai. It is your life. How you plan, it depends on you. Sabka baat sun liye, sabse information le liye. Now it depends on you, how are you planning this.
So planning is a skill. Yes.
I cannot hear you. Cannot hear you.
So aapne sabko, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you.
सो आपने सबसे डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स लिया एंड यू इनकॉर्पोरेटेड दैट इन योर ओन वे ऑफ हाउ यू वांट टू एग्जीक्यूट इट.
एग्जैक्टली, बिकॉज़ एट द लास्ट इट इज माय चॉइस टू मेक द प्लानिंग. सो आई नीड टू मेक द प्लानिंग इन सच अ वे व्हिच इज कंफर्टेबल टू मी. सो प्लानिंग इज अ स्किल, बन जाएगा, धीरे धीरे बन जाएगा इफ यू कीप ऑन ट्राइंग एवरी डे. ऑन द फर्स्ट डे योर प्लानिंग विल बी अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ, बट आफ्टर वन मंथ योर प्लानिंग विल बी स्पॉट ऑन.
Absolutely. Now, one thing was very peculiar thing, right? Like you do your own learning and all of that thing, right? Now, your ma'am also told you that, hey, you have to teach a lot of other people and to do all ML or AI or something like that, right? Now, it is a human task, right? It's not like easy. First of all, you have to learn, you have to put your college, and then you also have to give an effort to this particular thing or building this community, right? So now, how was your take in terms of what was your philosophy or what was your idea in spreading the knowledge?
Spreading the knowledge based on data science.
Yes, based on data science.
First thing, whenever you want to spread any knowledge or whenever you want to share any knowledge, share with the people who have the same enthusiasm as yours. If you tell a person data science is a very good field, you'll get a very good salary. Even though he's not interested, if he listen the word salary, he'll say, "Haan, main karunga. I like data science." You don't want to share the information with him because he is coming to you just because of the salary. But if you share the same knowledge with the person who is very much excited than you, who has a great enthusiasm like you, then if you share the knowledge with him and you don't do anything, he will eventually do it by himself because he is having the same motivation as you. Then may I share the knowledge? It is very important how you choose the starting two people. So if I am the first member of the route and I need to choose my left hand side people and my right hand side people. Let's take an example. Left is the girls group and right is the boys group. So it very purely depends how I choose the right member, the first member. Because if he's not very excited, if he's just coming for the salary sake, kya pata kal news mein aaja, if by chance there is a news tomorrow telling that data science is not the sexiest job in 21st century, he might leave it. He might say that, bro, you know what? Blockchain is very interesting. I might go for blockchain. So the entire tree is broken now because he was the root of it. Now he has left them. So I need to share the information with such people who are smarter than me, who thinks that this is a really great thing which Manish is doing and he has the same integrity with me. Integrity in the sense, I'll share the knowledge with him. He feels this is a great knowledge. He's smarter than me. He may betray me in the future. I don't need that kind of people who betrays me when they see profit. I need to share the knowledge with the people who has an integrity with me, who thinks that, jo Manish Sharma bol raha hai, wo sahi hai. And he should also think that, yes, I can do this. जब ऑल दिस थिंग्स मैच विथ ईच अदर तो एक वाइब बन जाता है तुम्हारे और पार्टनर के बीच में एक वाइब बन जाता है दैट यू कैन कम्युनिकेट थ्रू योर आईज टेलिंग दैट यू नो व्हाट वी विल डू दिस नाउ व्हेन यू से दिस ही नोज व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सो यू वांट टू फाइंड दैट काइंड ऑफ पीपल गिव द पावर टू देम एंड देन यू जस्ट सिट एंड वॉच योर कम्युनिटी बिल्ड
दिस इज सही है सही है You have told us about a mini startup story, Manish. And you're building a right foundation in terms of A, how to share knowledge, how to build the foundation of choosing people, and also, setting the principles or foundations right from the get-go itself. That way, when you are like moving ahead, you know what principles you are and you don't break that ever. Right, because of which you are already constantly building on your already capacity that you have. Awesome, that's great to know, Manish. Now, Manish, one more thing is like you've basically got so many internships, right? Now, having an intern, like you're telling me, and the fourth year students are preparing for internships. And maybe in traditional, maybe in data, not in data science or in data science, but they're preparing for that. Now you have already bagged so many internships. How did you differ? What made you do all that and, get the confidence to get yourself in front of companies and bag those internships?
Okay. So we will break these questions. In order to get an internship, there are generally two things. One thing is your technical thing, how good you are in some skills, what are the skills you know. And the second thing is how you communicate that skills. Let's take an example. Let's take the example of data science. What happens in data science when you're doing some client work? Your client doesn't know what is machine learning, what is deep learning. He doesn't know anything. He just needs the result. Now, I being a guy who is very good at skills, I know everything about skills. I know this is mean, this is median, this is mode, this is called a standard deviation, this is a graph. I know everything. But my client doesn't know that. So if I tell my client, as you can see, the share is going 25% above and 30% drop, and I can see that there is 25% deviation between that, he doesn't know anything. But if another guy says, sir, aapko dikh raha hai, ye graph upar ja raha hai, that means your company is in profit. Now, there is a very different meaning between the first guy and the second guy. First guy is talking in a very complex term, and the second guy is talking in a very simpler term. So here, communication is very important. So the second part when I'm talking about communication, you should have a communication skill in such a way that you can share what you're thinking in a simple manner. It is called as Feynman's technique. What does Feynman technique says? That if you're not able to share your knowledge to a 10-year-old child, you don't know that knowledge perfectly. Coming to the skills area, you know that for data science, many people do NumPy, Panda, machine learning, deep learning, everything. But this, there should be some kind of X factor which differentiate you from the rest of the people.
Couple of things you mentioned, Manish. One thing is business context. What the stakeholder wants to know, and you speak in that language. And second thing is, you not only focus on learning the algorithms or the techniques, but you also learn how to deploy. Deployment would mean how you serve it to end users for your stakeholders. Your stakeholders may be, they are the business and they want their users, maybe let's say Swiggy itself, right? They want their app users to get the results of some search within 2 seconds or 3 seconds, right? Or recommendations within 2 seconds, right? When a recommendation engine might be running behind, right? So these elements are very crucial to how you portray yourself. And so how did you get to these things? Like, did somebody teach you or you figured it out? How did this knowledge come to you?
So let me first answer this question, that why deployment is necessary for the beginner. Let's imagine you have made your project. You have made a very good project. But that project is in your system. When you say, Manish, I have made a very good project, can you please check this project? So now I have to do two things. Either go to your GitHub repository, fork your project, download in my system, and then try to play. Or the second thing is that you can directly share one link. I'll open that link and I can see your system on the cloud. I can see your project on the cloud. The second thing is very efficient. The recruiter won't download all your project and try to check in his system. He doesn't have so much time. If you just give a link to your project, he can directly see the link in the URL cloud and then he can check. So this is kind of X factor which makes you different from the basic beginner level. Beginner level has made your project. You too have made your project. But on top of that project, you are deploying that project. So that will give you an added advantage. Now, it is not like you have to be very good at deployment, do the AWS thing, do the GCP, Azure, Docker. No, there are very basic deployments. There is Heroku platform. There is Streamlit platform. So I have done around 5 to 6 deployment. And among that, 4 to 5 are on Streamlit. And I don't consider that as a disadvantage. I take that as an advantage because these are the factors which help me land a job, land an internship.
So, absolutely.
There are some couple of videos on YouTube, and I want to give shout out to Krish Nayak, deployment using Streamlit. That is a very beginner friendly, very easy. Just try to deploy your project onto cloud. You'll have a very small idea what is deployment. This will help you in the later stage. So, this is one. This is also another thing that when you are trying to learn something, try to go a little extra mile. Try to go a little ahead than the people. One more thing which is very necessary is I see many people that they learn some skills. They are not very good at that skills, but they mention that skill in their resume. So now if they're mentioning that skill in your resume and if the recruiter points that skill and if we ask questions based on that skill and if you're not able to answer that skill, the recruiter will keep on asking the same question based on only that skill. Recruiter always wants to reject you, but you want to defend yourself. So don't...
Null hypothesis, reject it.
Correct, exactly. Don't add those skills which are very hype and you just know the basics of it. Let it be short, let it be sweet, let it be crisp and simple, but have a very strong command over the skills which you're mentioning in your resume. So when I got to know about this, I deleted around 4 to 5 skills from my resume. Because I was afraid that if a recruiter asked me that and I'm not able to answer that, this is giving a negative impact on the recruiter, even though I have good amount of project and good amount of experience. So these are some couple of things which you need to mention in your resume.
So basically, in a nutshell, if you're working on projects, focus on delivering it so that the recruiter can play around and see with it. That means, in short, deploy it. Now, you said there are Heroku. There is what else did
AWS,
you say?
There is GCP.
AWS, there is GCP, Azure, right? And some of the free tiers are also available here. And there are also things like RPubs, Tableau, if you want to show a dashboard, right? So there are a couple of other free platforms where you can actually deploy a completely live project. So leverage these platforms.
So they now say only that if you make something, try to do it till the end. Matlab, beech mein jaake ruk mat jao. If your project is, let's take an example. If your project takes 100 days to complete and you have completed that in 70 days, 80 days, in the remaining 20 days, don't take rest thinking that I have made my project. In those 20 days, try to see what my project doesn't have and what is the thing which my recruiter wants to see from me. So try to think on that perspective and try to build your project. It's not like don't get up when you're tired. Get up when you're done with your project. This is a
super, super. This is going to be a good title to keep on this, Manish. So, okay, good. Now, very interesting things you're bringing out, Manish. Like now what the recruiter wants to see, right? I see a lot of people that rarely prepare for this particular thing. And when I say rarely prepare, they feel they have done some projects and they feel they stop there. But let's say, you know, you're applying for an internship in XYZ company. How do you read that company? How do you think what they're going to look for that? That is also a skill. That is a research skill. So how do you do that, Manish?
Let's take an example. I'm applying for a company called as XYZ. The first thing which you need to do is try to check what does that company do. Because this is one of the things which I've seen many people doesn't do. So if a recruiter asks you, what do you think about XYZ? If I'm not able to answer that, I am 95% rejected. So first you need to check what is that company and what is that company deals with. The second thing which I usually do is try to practice some tongue twister before the interview. This will help you not to get fumbled during the interview process. Because during the interview process, even though you know some concept, but you're not able to communicate properly and you're like... So the interview, the recruiter thinks that you don't know that. So... try to practice some tongue twisters 5 to 10 minutes before the interview so that you can communicate your things properly and be confident, be very confident, but don't be overconfident. There is a very thin line between confidence and overconfence. Confidence is must. Even though you don't know the answer, just tell him that, sir, I don't know the answer, but I am very confident on myself that I can learn these topics and I can deliver it to you within a short span of time. And so knowing the company is a very important thing. And then what have you written in your resume? That is very important thing. You should have a very good command over that subject. And at the last, when the recruiter asks you, do you have any questions to me? Or do you want to ask them? That is the point where the power is in your hand now. You should always ask some questions. See, I cannot tell that I'm a professional guy who has cracked many interviews. No, I'm just a basic guy who have learned something from the people who have met and I've learned something from the YouTube. They say, and I also say, that try to ask some questions to the recruiter. You can ask anything. Sir, how is your work experience in this company? Sir, what according to you, how is your daily task in this company? You're just trying to make a little casual between the interviewer so that he thinks that you're actually interested in his company. This is the reason you're asking questions to him. If you are interviewing me, the interviewer has gone very well, and you say me that, Manish, kuch questions hai? And I'm like, nahi, sir, I don't want to ask any questions. This shows that I'm not interested in that company. If I was actually interested in that company, I will mm-hmm. ask one or two questions. So these are some few key points which people generally tend to miss, and this becomes a large factor on the rejection process. So if I'm able to fill in those small gaps, tab to mile jayega internship. And I need to also say that I got my first internship after 54 applications got rejected. So don't think that I have applied for 10 internships. I did not get 10 internships. I think I should move on. So if I would have thought in the same way, I would have not got 5 to 6 internships today. So
absolutely,
it is just the first break. The first internship is very difficult to get. And now if you get your first internship, now you have some work experience on your resume. So aage ka to building block bante jayega.
Just like your first girlfriend.
So the thing is, don't stop. Keep on experimenting and keep and also try to after the interview, try to write it down, try to jot down what are the things which went wrong. Because the things which are going right, uspe zyada dhyan mat do. The things which are not going right, that is the thing which you need to focus on. So
got it.
Just think that I was not able to tell about the company. So learn about these things, and in the next interview, be very good. You have to be very good at the specific questions, and try to guide the interview by yourself. What are the skills which you say are the questions which the recruiter asks? If Kunal sir says, Manish, you have made a deep learning project.
Streamlight.
If you have made a deep learning project, what is a deep learning project? If I say very complex term, sir, I have made this deep learning project using RNN and LSTM, and that is very good. So I am giving a power to recruiter son, and now he might ask me questions. What is RNN? What is LSTM? Right.
Now, so dig a hole where you don't want to go there.
Exactly. So now if I'm not able to answer RNN and LSTM, he'll just think that I have copied this project from GitHub and I have put this into my resume.
So even if you do a very simple project, right? There is no simple project actually. In fact, even if you use logistic regression and do it, and if you're able to explain logistic regression very well, then you've nailed it.
Exactly. So you have a very good command on the resume, on the skills which you mentioned. Don't think that last mein jaake AWS dal diya chota sa to koi dekhega nahi. The recruiter is seeing everything. He might anytime ask you.
He has a network running. He knows when students are hiding stuff there.
Exactly. So if you have done 10 good and usme se 3-4 bad chala gaya, 3-4 negative ho gaya, there might be some fumble thing that this guy is a little bit off. I might not select him. So don't give any chance to the recruiter to say that he doesn't know anything. Be very confident.
Absolutely, Mani. So now another thing that I always mention to folks that, like you said, 54 interviews to crack first interview, and then
I cannot say 54 interviews. I had applied for
54 applications. So 54 applications. That is a number game, right? Truly number game. You give 100, then out of 100, one thing should work. But the only catch that Manish you're telling here is that improvise from your past learning. Like,
exactly.
Dil pe mat lo. Dil pe mat lo.
Exactly.
Right. Oh, if you take that, then you have lost, right?
Like, you have lost. Exactly.
The only way is you do it, you experience, improvise, do it, experience, and keep improvising, right? Like, that's the only way. And that's how you got your first internship. So, let's talk about a moment of, a lot of folks are very interested in knowing what is after the internship. Now, there is a lot of hype around these topics, ML, AI, and all of that thing, right? But after you get into the company, you realize something. And what is that something that you realize? Like, what really happens in a company? And, what you have believed that, okay, this is how ML and AI is. There is some shift in your mindset. What was that?
Okay, in the first internship which I got, I was a solo member of the team. So I won't consider that I won't take an example for that internship. I'll take the example of the second internship. In the second internship, when I applied, I had a team of 5 members. In the first meet itself, I got to know that I'm not the smartest guy in the room. There are people who are way more smarter than you. but they just don't know how to communicate. So now when you're dealing with five smart peoples, the first thing is that you should accept that you are not smart. If you if you think that you are smart, you won't consider other people's point. If tum apne aap ko smart mante ho, if the other guy is telling top-notch things, you won't consider that. You'll say like, "Wo toh mere ko aata." So first accept that you are not smart. Second, try to listen to the teammate what he's telling. Because that is a very important point. When you join an internship, there is a project which is given to you. And it is not like you can complete this project within 1 or 2 days. There is around 1 week of brainstorming which takes place to make some product.
I enjoy the brainstorming sessions the most.
Brainstorming is the best part according to me, because the teammates which you have, they'll give their full potential. And during that period, you'll come to know that how much you thought that you are smart, you're not that smart. Right. You are just going in one way, but there are people who are going in many ways. They are able to look the concept from 360 degree, and you are just focusing from one direction. So these are the things which many people think that agar main internship mein join ho gaya, I'll get the amount. There were some internships where they said me particularly that Manish, if you're not able to complete the task, you won't get your pay. So it also depends that if you're joining an internship and then you're not doing the task, you are just roaming here then telling that I got my internship and you're uploading post in LinkedIn, that doesn't mean that tumhe paisa mil jayega. Paisa nahi milta hai ki baar. When you do the task, then you get paid. When you don't do the task, it doesn't get paid. So these are some facts. Jo internship jab join ho jaoge, then you come to this. The brainstorming part is the best.
I agree. Whiteboard when you have blank sheet.
Exactly.
You don't know what the heck you're going to solve for and what the outcome is going to be, or even have a possibility that you can solve it. Right? That's where every data scientist starts when you have a new problem statement.
And that is a difficult point, because you have a very whiteboard, clean board. You don't know where to start. You have your task, you don't know where to start. That is the point where it is little bit tough. Now when you get to a starting point, then you can go ahead one by one, do everything.
And so, execution becomes very fast, right? After that, Manish, like once you've figured out, like once you've cracked the major pieces, then execution is like bunch of trials, and then you get to a solution somehow or the other, right?
Correct, exactly.
Okay. And one more part of the job, the internship is like, you know, a myth between how much ML you do and how much data manipulation you do, right? So is that true? Do you spend a lot of time on data manipulation and making the data ready for at least AI and ML?
So yes, according to me, from the past 4 to 5 internships, I think that 80 to 85% of the time is being spent on data collection, data pre-processing and data cleaning. Your model building is very easy. It just takes around 2 to 3 hours or 1 day to do. But your data collection, your data pre-processing, data cleaning, data extraction, feature engineering, feature selection, these are the points and these are the domains which takes lots of time in your internship area. They say that ML is a box. Good data gives you good output. Bad data gives you bad output. So before you're giving any data to your model, try to clean it as much as possible. जितना क्लीन तुम्हारा डेटा होगा उतना अच्छा तुम्हें आउटपुट आएगा. नो प्रॉब्लम इफ योर डेटा इज बीइंग रिड्यूस्ड इनटू हाफ. इफ यू हैव 10,000 डेटा पूरा क्लीन करके यू आर कमिंग टू 7,000 डेटा, नो प्रॉब्लम. यू हैव लॉस्ट 3,000 डेटा, बट दोस 3,000 डेटास वे नॉट गुड डेटा. दे वे लाइक वीड्स आउट ऑफ ग्रास. सो तुम्हें ग्रास देना है, नॉट द वीड्स. सो एक्सट्रैक्ट ऑल द बैड डेटा, गिव योर गुड डेटा एंड देन यू विल गेट योर गुड रिजल्ट्स. After that, you can do your trial, hit and trial method. But it generally takes lot amount of time for data cleaning, data abstraction, all your feature engineering thing, everything.
Okay. Now, Manish, one more thing is there in this particular thing is that a lot of courses are focused on the ML building part of it, right? But not a lot of courses are focused on this data collection, data munging, these techniques and all of that thing. So these skills are very rare to come to pick up and to understand, and only through like internships you get it. But how do you keep practicing these data munging skills, and what do you say to students who are still not thinking that this part is important?
So first thing I want to mention is that I have took only one course till now to learn data science. And I generally think that taking course is not good. Why do people take course? The first thing is that people only take course because they have all the things ready in one format. They don't have to search everything on the Google. They have everything in front of you. They just need to learn each thing one by one. Now, why that is not good? Let's imagine I'm making a course. I want my course to be very good. So I don't want my course to get any negative comments. So in order to get only positive comments and in order to be my course good, I will take those machine learning tasks which are easy. Because if I take tough tasks, there are chances that I may make some mistakes. That very mistakes will point. Lead to negative points. So if I'm taking easy tasks and the people who is taking my course, he will just learn these easy tasks. And this easy task is not which you see in your real life. There, I have seen many courses, they take some CSV file and they'll use that CSV file in the entire course. So this is not good. You should have the knowledge of how to use Google, how to search for specific things. So it is basically don't purely depend that how many ye course khatam kar liya, I have the required information. No, it's not like that. Always gain information from the 360 degree point of view. Jahan se information mil raha hai, le lo. It is not like, let's take an example. There is a concept called as XG boost or random forest. Kunal has made a YouTube video. I have made a YouTube video. So I will share the knowledge which I know. Kunal will share the knowledge which he knows. So if some random person comes and he sees my YouTube video, he cannot say that I am very good at random forest. He can just say that I am good at random forest, which Manish has taught. So agar ek person apne dimag mein ye sochta, if a person thinks that I have completed this course, Manish Sharma's course, and I am ready for my interview, that is wrong. He needs to also go to Google. He needs to also refer some articles, some blogs, everything in order to get the 360 degree view of one topic so that he can answer any questions based on that field point of view. So this is why I majorly recommend the people not to take course, learn the skills, how to use Google, make a very good connection on LinkedIn, because LinkedIn, why am I telling LinkedIn is very good? Because when you start data science, it is very overwhelming. It is very intimidating way to start from because there are a large number of information. So if you contact some person who has some guidance in this field, he may directly point you that, yahan se start karo. Now, when he says, yahan se start karo, now you got a very focused view. Okay, yahan se bola ki, yahan se start. Now he'll start from there. Now his 50% of the job is done. Kahan se start karna hai, wo to pata chal gaya. The remaining 50%, he will check that YouTube videos. Now, after some watching around 10 to 20 YouTube videos, he will gain the mindset, jisse usko khud pata chal jayega, now I should go in which direction. He will automatically gain that knowledge. So, it is like, generally, if you are going for some deployment courses, then it is good. You can take some course. But if you are learning what is data cleaning, data preprocessing, how to download data, how to scrape data, don't generally focus on one course and tell that I have completed this course, I know this.
Right.
Focus on 80 to 90% skills of Googling, how to Google stuff. You'll make some error. And after 10 to 20 years, if you close your eyes and think that I know this concept, I had read this on Stack Overflow first paragraph. Wo yaad aa jata hai. If you close your eyes, you will get to remember
it. Yeah, I call this learning by error. Like if you don't make mistakes, you are not learning.
Exactly. It's like a Counter-Strike game. Let's take an example. This is a CSGO game or Counter-Strike game. If you're not facing any enemies, that means you're not going to the right direction. Unless and until you face any enemies or unless and until you find some error or mistake in your path, that means you are going in a good direction. If you think
kud ke khelna hai tab seekhte hai na enemy aayega to tab kud ke maarne ka.
Exactly. If you are just moving in a direction and you don't find any difficulties, That is not the right direction. You have to change your path there.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, another important part you're doing, you mentioned LinkedIn, Manish. And you have nailed LinkedIn pretty much. I've seen so many profiles. And particularly, I like your profile because, hey, you not only post, but you're doing good engagements with other people's content also. Right? Like you're equally involved in posting and engaging. And you know, when you're engaging, right, I've seen you consistently, you're engaging with few set of people and you're expanding to new people and all of that thing. Now that is a skill not taught by anybody. So how did you end up using LinkedIn, Manish?
I guess this is one of the best choice which I made using LinkedIn. It started in the month of July 2020. When my friend suggested that, Manish, you're learning machine learning, go to LinkedIn. You'll find many people who are studying machine learning. You can interact with them. Many people get confused that, okay, I'll make my LinkedIn profile, but what should I mention in my LinkedIn profile? I don't have any skills. I don't have any project. What should I mention in my skill? And what are the posts which should I make? So if you go to my first post in LinkedIn, my first post was, I am not able to give a certain path for XGBoost. Can anyone please help me? So my first post was help from people. So if you think that I don't have any content to post, you're not ready. Tum kabhi post nahi karoge. You should not think that kya post karun. Post it. In the first post, I got 23 views. Now generally I... In my highest post views, I got 57,000 views and around 600 likes. So these are the views which came to me when I started using LinkedIn and when I started posting. So aap post karte jao. Starting me, you won't get many views, you won't get any success. Neither will you get likes. Because if you're posting about XGBoost, many people know XGBoost. So they might not like your post because they know that what is XGBoost. But if a person who knows ki ek post ka engagement ka value kitna hai, he will like. Because when I posted my post, no one used to like. So I used to feel bad that no one is interacting with me. What should I do? Now when I see new people coming onto the LinkedIn and they're not getting any likes or they're not getting any comment, I, having a very good background of 4,000 to 5,000 connections, I will like their post and I will comment their post. Now when I do that, my post is being shown to my LinkedIn connections. So now he's getting that extra push from my side. Because at that point, I didn't have any support. So now when I have the power in my hands, why not support the people who are starting this? Then when I got the internship, then I started filling my LinkedIn profile. LinkedIn, jitna acha banega profile, you'll get offers from the recruiters. Exactly.
Right. And so still now also you get offers, even though you are already working in some internship companies.
Out of 8 internship, all my 5 internships are from LinkedIn. So all the 5 internships, recruiter contacted me. The current 2 internships which I'm doing, the NLP at Analytics Way and Machine Learning from SkillZen, both were contacted by the recruiters to me. So don't think ki mujhe kon aayega, mujhe kon follow karega, who will contact me.
People will come.
You don't have to think about the moon. Tumhare samne gadha hai, pehle gadha ko bharo. There is a hole in front of you. First try to fill that hole, then you can think about something else. Build your LinkedIn profile very good. Just start posting everything. Start connecting with the people who are in the same field. Try to engage with them. And then you'll eventually see that your views are getting increased. Your profile views is getting increased. And always add your profile photo in your LinkedIn. I have seen many people that they don't have profile pic in their LinkedIn profile and they ask me some help. Even though I'm willing to help, I might like take some... Kaun karega? Because he doesn't have his profile pic. He neither has his LinkedIn correctly. It's like everything jumbled up. So I don't feel that sense to help me. So a profile photo, that is your first point of connection between you and that guy. Connection acha ban
gaya. Be a person. Be show that trustworthiness. It creates that.
Exactly. So
put a nice photo there. Yeah. Exactly. Doesn't hurt. Not these like Tinder, right?
So these are the things that you have to focus. Just keep on posting. Don't थिंक कि ये क्या बोलेगा वो क्या बोलेगा, अरे दिस इज वेरी सिंपल टॉपिक, हु विल लाइक मी, हु वांट, जिसको सपोर्ट करना है वो सपोर्ट करेगा.
देर इज ऑलवेज दैट थिंग मनीष, लाइक when you take a one step, right, there is always another set of people who have take who want to take that step that you took.
Exactly.
And there will always be some people who like your post because you have taken that step. Exactly. And it inspires them to take the same step that you took.
Exactly. at the beginning, I have seen this in my life, that when I started using LinkedIn, there were many people who said me ki are yaar tera to kitna kam followers, you don't have much connection, you don't have project. If I अगर मैं उनका सुन लेता, इफ आई यूज टू टेक देयर इन्फॉर्मेशन, आज मेरा लिंक्डइन प्रोफाइल अच्छा नहीं होता. टुडे माय प्रोफाइल वुडंट हैव बीन वेरी गुड. सो जस्ट नेग्लेक्ट द पीपल हु आर टेलिंग बैड अबाउट यू, जस्ट फोकस ऑन द पॉजिटिव साइड एंड बिल्ड योर प्रोफाइल. एंड देयर इज अ वेरी
लिंक्डइन हैज या या प्लीज
देयर इज अ वेरी फेमस कोट, आई डोंट नो द पर्सन हु सेड दिस, ही सेड व्हेन अ पीपल थ्रो स्टोन्स एट यू, it depends on you what you do with that stone. Build a wall between it or build a bridge between that. So you're taking the wall as negative and you're taking the bridge as positive. So koi bhi tumhe negative comment fek raha hai, take that as a positive and try to see whether he's actually telling a good negative thing. If I say, Kunal sir, your video doesn't have proper audio quality. So this is a constructive criticism. This is a thing which you will focus on. But when I say, sir, your background is not good, aapko farak nahi padega because my content is good. I know the people who are trusting me. I know my content is good. Agar ek banda bol raha hai, my content is not good, and there are 10,000 people who are supporting me, right hand side mein jao na, left mein kyun jana hai?
Sahi hai Manish. And like you are such an inspiring guy to speak to, Manish. Plus, I hope you have literally given every intern, every person who's looking for an internship in the data science, ML or AI field, all the formula you have just laid it there. Very simply put, very down to earth. And also one more important factor you have given is the time management, right? Like planning your day. A lot of people fail in terms of planning the day. Like they'll sit down and they'll think, ab kya karna hai? You should, when you're doing the activity, you shouldn't plan what you're doing. Exactly. In fact, you should just enter and do the activity because that takes also mental power, right? Mm-hmm. So a lot of people don't, have that, which is again, not to blame anybody because nobody has taught them. It comes out of that intensity to do something and to have a goal and to pursue it relentlessly, right? And so you have like nailed it. And I hope the audience that is looking at this gets as much inspiration as they can to take their journey from learning to the internship. And then not only that, continuing that journey and putting it forward, right? And also sharing back in terms of what Manish was saying, right? Like instead of, not helping others, he chose to help others. Liking those people, those who are coming new to the platform, uplifting them, and also is working with 2,000 other people to uplift their dreams. So thank you, Manish, for sharing your journey. At some point of time, I was getting goosebumps because you're telling so many good things and really inspiring and enterprising to hear you, Manish.
Thank you so much, sir. Maja aa gaya aapse baat karke.